धन्यवाद कृष्णचर्य प्रभु।
धन्यवाद महाराज।
धन्यवाद। हाउ आर यू डूइंग?
I am fine today. I've just traveled from KL to Kluang today.
Oh.
Maharaj, have you been to Kluang in Malaysia?
No.
No, huh? Oh, it's near to Singapore.
Oh. Johor I went, but I not went to other, places.
Johor Bahru, you have been near to Johor Bahru, yes.
Yeah, Johor I went. Johor I went.
Oh, Johor. I remember you were in Johor. Yes, I forgot about it. Really, I met you in Johor Bahru. Okay, yeah. Maharaj.
So, your health is okay?
How is your health? Is okay. Health is okay. I went and checked the doctor, and the doctor said everything seems to be okay now. The doctor is happy about my health problem.
Mm-hmm.
And he asked me to continue the medicine for another 3 months.
Okay.
Then come back and see him after that. After 6 months, I will come and see him.
Okay.
Every 6 months.
How is Didi doing? Okay, she's okay. She's okay. Didi is okay.
Yes. What's that, Maharaj?
How is Didi doing? She's okay. Hare Krishna, can you hear me? Hare Bol. Hare Krishna, Uma Didi, can you hear? Hare Krishna. Uma Didi, can you hear me? Seems to be some problem with the sound. Krishnacharya Prabhu, can you hear me? Hare Krishna.
Hello, Maharaj.
Can you hear me now? Yes, I can hear you.
Yes. Yeah. Okay, Maharaj.
I think her mic is. Didi is okay? Her health?
Didi is okay. She's with me here today.
Okay. How are
we? We are all back at home already.
How are the devotees in KL? They are all okay?
In KL, devotees are all okay. I was there in the temple for with the center for 3 days there.
Mm-hmm.
In KL, when I was in KL, then I had to go and do some personal work in German.
Mm-hmm.
Then I came back, and after that I came back here. My mother-in-law was very sick. She had a heart attack here, so I had to rush back here in Kluang. So she's in hospital now. So we came back tomorrow morning. I'll go and see her because of COVID-19.
Mm-hmm.
We are not allowed to go and see one by one. We have to go and see.
How is the COVID situation there? Is very less?
Situation is good. Situation is okay. Very less, but the thing is, it's keep on increasing the amount of people getting COVID. Their sickness.
And government is helping?
It's less than 100. It's less than 100 always. Yes, Maharaj.
Government is helping people?
Yes, helping, yes.
Okay. In India also, actually, the cases are going up, but I think last few days it is remaining stable, but every day like 80,000 is coming, minimum 80,000, 90,000. not increasing, but it remains the same, you know, the number every day coming that much. Our death rate is less.
Yes.
Uma Didi, Dandavat, everything is okay with you?
Yes, Maharaj, Dandavatana. Everything fine, Maharaj.
Very nice.
Grace of you and Guru and Gauranga is good, Maharaj.
Very nice. London is now very cold.
Yes, Maharaj, starting cold.
Okay. All right. Let us begin our Sangha. मुखम करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंघायते गिरी जत्कृपा तमहं वंदे श्रीगुरुदिनतारिणं मम ज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति स्वरूपमदर स्वामिति नामिने नमो सद्भक्तमने मणिपूरिभवे च प्रभुपादलस्य दवानि प्रचार निरतायते पूज्य श्री गुरुवर्ग वंदित महाभावान्वित सदा पूर्वापर्य परंपरा प्रचलित प्राच्य प्रमुर्तकिते भक्तिर निर्मल निजरस निवृतम संरक्षकम सादरम वंदे श्री गुरुदेव नाथ शिराचार्य वर्जम निजम गुरुवाभीष्ट सुपुरकम गुरुगणैराशीष संभूषितम चिंता चिंत समस्त भेद निपुणम शिरूप पंथानुगम गोविंद विदम उज्ज्वलम भरतनम भक्तान्वितम सुंदरम वंदे विश्व गुरुम च दिव्य भगवत प्रेम्णा हि बीजपदम अथो नत्वा मंत्र गुरुन गुरुन भागवतार्थदान व्यासान जगत गुरु नत्वा ततो जय मुदिरये वृंदाय तुलसी दिव्याय प्रियाय केशवस्य च कृष्ण भक्ति पदे देवी सत्यवत्ते नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवा साधि श्री गौर भक्तविंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे और हम दंडवत प्रणाम टू ऑल द डिवोटीज टू ऑल द वैष्णवस बाय द ग्रेस ऑफ डिवोटीज बाय द ग्रेस ऑफ वैष्णवस वी हैव सम हम्बल अपॉर्चुनिटी टू पार्टिसिपेट इन सर्विस ऑफ लॉर्ड एंड ही डिवोटीज वी प्रे फॉर देयर मर्सी देयर ब्लेसिंग्स either any topic anybody wants to discuss today, any questions or comments on anything? All right. So today we were thinking to discuss a subject on we are chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, but in which way shall we chant? So yesterday we were discussing how Hare Krishna chanting and Ekadasi observing, they are not different. Jagannanda Pandit says they are one and same because both the activities are considered as bhajan under the direction of a Vaishnav, direction of a devotee. So Hare Krishna chanting or observing Ekadasis, when it is done under the direction of a Vaishnav, then that is those activities, both the activities are considered bhajan and there cannot be any difference in that. And when actually we are being given this Hare Krishna Maha Mantra initiation. Dandavat Damayanti Didi, Hare Krishna.
Dandavat Pranam Maharaj.
Dandavat, you are okay? Everything is fine?
Yes, yes. Hare Krishna.
Hari Bol, Dandavat. You are doing nice study? You are studying properly? Haribala, huh? You're studying properly. Very nice. Are you also sometime reading Bhagavad Gita?
Some slokas?
Bhagavad Gita. Are you reading?
Bhagavad Gita, there's right?
You saw that. You have Bhagavad Gita with you in your house?
She has.
Okay.
She has.
Sometime you learn how to chant some slokas and we'd like to listen from you. You can chant here sometime and we'll be happy to listen. How you are chanting Bhagavad Gita slokas. We'd like to see. Okay. Not only you learn ABCD, cat, dog, ball, bat, all those things, but also learn what Krishna is saying in Gita. You know Krishna?
Yes.
Very nice, huh? You like him?
Yeah, I like him.
Are you offering some laddu, jalebi, everything to Krishna every day? Some sweet?
Yeah.
Very nice. Very nice. Very nice. Hare Krishna. So, when we are chanting, when Guru gives us this Hare Krishna mantra to us, then he just not tell us, just chant this. He gives us some kind of restriction, certain things you cannot do. Otherwise, the results will not be very good. You have to avoid the offenses. Mainly 10 offenses that is being told by Guru. So that is known as aparadha. Aparadha. Do you know, anybody knows what is the meaning of aparadha? Anybody knows what is the meaning of aparadha? Anybody knows what is the meaning of aparadha?
Offenses like the wrong things.
Krishna Sriya Prabhu, you know what is the meaning of aparadha? Your mic is muted. You have to unmute your mic to speak. When you speak, you have to unmute your mic.
It's offenses, Maharaj.
Yes.
Offenses against the normal. But you're supposed to do normal. You go against the...
What is the meaning of aparadha?
Saying offensive.
Aparadha?
Aparadha is offense. Offenses.
Anybody know? Suma Didi know?
Offense against them.
Uma Didi? Do you know what is the meaning of aparadha? Aparadha means there is Radharani's name is there. That activity which is not pleasing to Srimati Radharani, that is known as aparadha. That activity which is not pleasing to Srimati Radharani. That means that which creates some kind of disturbance in the service of her Lord Krishna, that improper mood, improper attitude, that is not, tolerated. A little bit of that is not tolerated. The pure servitor like Srimati Radharani and her servitors. That's why the first thing when some service is given to us, in the time of initiation, Hare Krishna, the aparadha is also introduced. Don't try to serve with some offensive attitude. Try to eliminate the offensive attitude. Displeasing attitude, which is displeasing Radharani and her camp, servitors. So among that, the first main, offense is Vaishnava aparadha. The devotees who have dedicated their life to serve the interest of Guru and Vaishnava, they are doing all those activities wonderfully. And if you are becoming envious and trying to act in a way which is trying to create some difficulties in their heart, then that type of thing will lead to some kind of problem in our spiritual life. It's not good. Damayanti Didi, who is this? Hare Krishna, Damayanti Didi. Who is this number you are telling? Are you there, Damayanti Didi?
Yes, Maharaj, can you hear me?
Yes.
Hello.
What is this number?
Yes, Maharaj, actually, this was one of my colleagues. He was in the office.
Okay.
So he used to, I mean, whenever I used to work, so he used to talk about Krishna and, you know, a lot of things.
Mm-hmm.
So share my knowledge.
She but wants then to join? She wants to join?
Yeah.
Our WhatsApp group or which group? Sangha.
This knowledge. Yeah, I'm thinking this knowledge because
she wants to join now the Zoom session.
Maybe from tomorrow or day after tomorrow he would be joining.
I see. Okay. You know how to invite anybody to our sangha? You have the link for them to that WhatsApp group. You have link?
I'll check, Maharaj, let me
send you here. You can, this is not the link. Sorry. You see that WhatsApp link?
Yes, Maharaj.
That link on the WhatsApp, if you can send to anybody who wants to join, just send that link and they can join our e-group. And then they will receive the messages. So, as I was telling, when Gurudev gives us this Hare Krishna chanting and instruction, that means he initiates into service world. First thing he instructs that you have to do this service, try to do this service with avoiding offensive mentality. And the main offense, the main offense is offense towards the holy name of the Lord. If you are in the offense towards the devotee, Vaishnavas, who are serving wonderfully the interest or the instruction of Guru, if you are trying to become offensive towards them, then whole of our that devotional creeper can be uprooted. It's known as mad elephant offense. So that mentality will not work. Hare Krishna, Komal. Komal Puyalji, Haribol, can you hear us? Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Guru.
Haribol, Dandavad.
Namaskar.
From Nepal, you joined?
From Nepal, long time ago, we met you here in Bhaktipur, you know?
Yes. Hajurla kosto cha, ramra huncha?
Ekdamai ramra cha.
So, Nepal.
Guru, how are you?
We are fine. Everything is okay. In Nepal, everybody is saying Rambro, Rambro. They're all become devotees of Lord Ram by the mercy of Sita Devi. Janakpur.
our Prime Minister is much engrossed by this idea that Ram is somebody from Thori, Nepal, and he.
That is offense. That is offense to think that Lord Krishna is from UP. And then Balaji is from Andhra Pradesh, and then Mahaprabhu from Bengal. To think like that, material identity, Lord, then that is an offense. That's why those Joy Vijay, they were standing at the gate of Vaikuntha. They seen Lord's devotee with some material vision. You are babies. And that's why they have to take the birth as demons. So what to talk about Lord? Even his devotees we cannot see with material vision.
In the matter of faith, whenever and wherever people happen to believe that.
Tell me, which country your soul belongs to? Which country your soul belongs
soul is
when you were dog. When you were dog, somewhere you were there. When you were bacteria, somewhere you were there. When you were plant, somewhere you were there. Like this, so many lives the soul takes. Yes. Sometime in the hole as a snake, and sometime in the tree as a bird. You are identified with that, all those things. As a mundane identity, yeah, that is not applicable to soul. And what to talk about Lord Bhagavan, who is beyond even super soul, with the source of even super soul. So all these people, these leaders, they have no education.
Politics.
They have no education.
Politics
is not bad.
Politics
is not bad.
Politics, they have this idea of populism, and they want to be popular, and they have a lot of political agenda while uttering these names.
Yes, politics is not bad if it is done under the direction of a Vaishnav, devotee. Vidura was a very devoted politician. He was always supporting the devotees. He was not going against the scriptural direction. So politics cannot be independent. Philosophy cannot be independent of religion. Science cannot be independent of religion. Everything must be centered around the absolute for his satisfaction. Everything must be done, not for our own satisfaction. So these are all the very important thing. People don't understand. And that's why they are suffering. Yes.
True.
Hare Krishna, Dandavat, Madan Mohan Prabhu, Hari Bol.
Hare Krishna Maharaj, Dandavat Pranam, Jai Srila Gurudev.
Jai Gurudev. You are okay? Everything is fine?
Yes, Maharaj. Thank you, Maharaj. Yes, Maharaj. Thank you.
Ram Mohan, Hari Bol, from where you joined? Hare Krishna, Ram Mohan. Your mic is muted. Hare Bol. Okay. Didn't know voice coming. So, we were discussing about the Hare Krishna chanting, how when Gurudev gives us this initiation, Diksha, he tells us that you can do this service, but be careful. Don't try to commit the offensive mentality, develop offensive mentality against devotees. First offense, he tells, against the Vaishnav. And also, never try to compare the holy name with some other lower forms. Krishna and his name are not different. Do not try to compare those things with, some great persons. Like that Mohesh Jogi was telling, Vaishnavas are giving this Hare Krishna and other Vaishnava mantras. I can also give you some transcendental sound. Mango used to give charge like $10. Then he used to give some sound like mango. As a mango, 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 they are chanting. And some saying, tree, 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 they are chanting like that. There is some difference between Tanmatra and Vaikuntha sound. And the sound that originates here is Tanmatra. And the sound that comes from the spiritual world is the Vaikuntha sound. There's a great difference between both of them. The material sound has some material conception, and spiritual sound has spiritual conception. On which spiritual plane that is coming, that type of potency that is bringing. So we cannot compare sound, the Hare Krishna Mahamantra, with any of the mundane conceptions, even lower, conception of the holy name. That will not be helpful. You cannot never compare that with demigods and, others. And then we should never become disobedient to Guru, Vaishnav. When we tell to Guru and Vaishnav something, then we should be, yes, Gurudev, yes, my dear devotee, Prabhu, or Maharaj, or Didi, or whatever, I will do this, we tell to devotee, and we don't do this. And that is an offense, actually. Because you promised it, and we're not doing that. that leads to some offense. And disobeying spiritual master is the greatest offense, actually. So one should never try to commit that type of, you know, offensive mentality. And we should not be very much offensive towards the revealed scriptures, the Grantha Bhagavat, and also Bhakta Bhagavat, who is revealing that sound to us, or that, you know, message to us from the scripture. We should not be offensive towards that. Revealing, you know, agent. Either scripture, they are also personalities. All the scriptures are personality, and that who is revealing us, they are also personality. And should not think that the service that we are doing, there is something imaginary. Chanting or whatever service the guru told, it is not imaginary thing. Offering bhoga, taking prasadam, all those things are not imaginary. Never to think them as some imaginary things. Don't try to misinterpret all those things, holy name and service, Vaishnav, Lord, by telling them Lord belongs to this country, that country. Don't try to misinterpret. Lord's name, don't give, you know, so whatever service Guru told you, do it as Guru told or Vaishnav told you. Don't try to add your conception there. That's not good. It's a very important thing. And you cannot accept service as compare it with some kind of, you know, pious activity that you are doing. Some kind of rituals that you are performing in your house for some mundane gain. Don't try to compare that. Some mundane gain, we are getting or doing all those things. That cannot be beneficial for the soul proper. And never try to create difficulties, more difficulties to the fallen souls. Those who have less faith, you are trying to create an opportunity for them to commit more offenses by telling some higher things, and there, so that they can blaspheme Guru, blaspheme Vaishnava, blaspheme scripture, all those things, then they will more fall down. They will fall down more. Then that will be very much harmful to yourself also. And after listening so many ways that Vaishnava has explained us, all this, you know, scriptural direction and knowledge, then if we are, you know, maintaining some mundane attachment, then that is also improper thing, very bad. That is what you can say. Something nice is offered to you and you are maintaining your attachment to lower things. Like that Indra was trying to maintain attachment and in the pig form to the stool. So we have to try to give up the lower interest. So these all things are told as the 10 offenses. But main thing in that is that Guru Krishna, they're telling us that never to develop some conception or some mentality that will be away from the interest of the Absolute. That will be creating some kind of disturbance in His service. And that will be displeasing His servitors, Radharani. That's why if you know Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when He used to do Sankirtan, somehow He used to do closed door in Sankirtan Raj in Sivas Thakur's house. He was not allowing those who unwanted, you know, disturbances to enter there. They will disturb the mood of their service. He cannot tolerate any, you know, a lower conception, you know, person to come into that type of, you know, thing. So same way, we are, our doors for advancement will be closed if we are maintaining some kind of other interest, other kinds of conceptions, which will be not satisfying to the Vaishnava, Guru, Sadhu. So this offensive mentality is the most important thing. Rules and regulations are one side. They are like mushrooms, Srila Sridhar Maharaj says. They can be easily followed. The kind of rules and regulations Hiranyakashipu followed, nobody can follow like that for such a long time. And yet, he has been counted as Asura. But difficult to overcome the offensive mentality. How to overcome the offensive mentality? Okay. Can you hear us? Kolam, Velam, can you hear us? Yeah. We cannot hear anything from you. Is your sound is coming? Our sound is coming to you. We cannot hear anything from you. You have to unmute your mic. Okay, seems to be some problem. So, this, you know, principle of like you are doing the sacrifice, offering ghee in the sacrifice, but you cannot add also water with that. You cannot do sacrifice by putting one spoon of ghee and one spoon of water together. That will not be, you know, helpful for the fire sacrifice. So we have to offer the service with a pure mentality. And to come to that platform, we are, you know, following that process. We are at present having so many, defects. So many anarthas that we are at present. And that's why we have to undergo the process of anartha nibruti. And that steps are there given. Adho saddha tata sadhu sangha bhajana kriya anartha nibruti. So saddha means having faith on Vaishnava. Then we take his association. Then we do service under him. And when we try to do service under the Vaishnava, then he can correct us and he can guide us towards purification of our bad habits, elimination of bad habits by the Vaishnava's direction. The Mahaprabhu told, who can chant the Mahamantra properly? Tunadapi sunicheno taruriva saishnuna amanino manadeno kirtaniya sadahari. Tunadapi sunicheno. One has to be more humble than the blade of grass. The necessary qualification. Without that, you know, humility. Anybody understand what is the meaning of humility? Do you remember Krishnacharya Prabhu? No, we cannot hear. If you, when you speak, you have to unmute your mic.
Okay. Humility is just a bit of humor. That means
difficult to hear you.
Hello.
Yes. What is the meaning of humility?
Humility is take it as not seriously, humility. Read with fun or something.
Madan Mohan Prabhu, do you know what is the meaning of humility?
Hare Krishna Maharaj, Dandavat Pranam.
Dandavat.
State of self negation.
You remember what Srila Sridhar Maharaj told about humility, what Saraswati Thakur told him? Srila Saraswati Thakur told, humility means that which we don't have when we have some exploitative spirit. Huh?
Yes, Maharaj.
And Srila Sipad Maharaj, he told us, I asked him, what is the humility? Srila Vaksha Damodar Maharaj, he told that humility means accepting the authority. That is humility. And you accept the authority. The authority of scripture, authority of Vaishnava. all these things. Huh? When you are doing a job in your company and you are not accepting the head of that company, that is not humility. When you are approaching the spiritual plane, then there are spiritual authorities. So we have to accept their authority and see the hand of Lord in everything. Like Trinadapi Sunicheno means when a blade of grass is not ordinary, you have to see. It is something extraordinary, that Sripad Bhakti Madhava Puri Maharaj says. People generally think blade of grass is ordinary and they proudly walk on the grass. But Sripad Puri Maharaj says, I see blade of grass as something extraordinary. We cannot produce that blade of grass in any of our laboratories. A wonderful thing, that blade of grass produced by Lord, that we cannot produce that. And without grass, the life cannot sustain on this planet. Grass is most essential thing. It biosphere is sustained. Without that, it's difficult. There will be so much problem that will be coming if that is not there. So one has to be more humble than a blade of grass. If one putting the feet on the grass and is going down, and when you're lifting again, it is coming up. But if somebody chastises us, some higher personality chastises us, Vaishnava chastises us, even though we don't have fault, then we accept it. Yes, I have more fault than what you have seen. We accept that. That type of attitude has to be developed. That is humility. Torurivo Saishna, one has to be more tolerant than the tree, Mahaprabhu says. Tolerant. A tolerance, how it will come, the tolerance. How one can tolerate? Dhandavad, Dr. Srinivas, Haribol.
Dhandavad, Maharaj, Dhandavad.
Dhandavad.
Srinivas, yes.
Yes, Haribol, happy to have you. You know what is the meaning of more tolerant than the tree? Actually, devotees, they don't have any expectation in return. They are ready to give everything. Like trees, ready to give its fruits, its flowers, everything. Its shade, everything tree wants to give without any expectation in return. It tolerates everything. If you don't give water also, it don't demand. It may die, but it will not demand. A devotee has to develop this type of attitude. If he wants to chant the holy name properly, he has to develop this type of attitude. Tarurīva saiṣṇuna amānina mānadena. Respecting those who are disrespecting us. Respecting those who are disrespecting us. Damayanti Didi, how can you do that? Hare Krishna, are you there? Damayanti Didi?
Hare Krishna, Maharaj.
Hare Krishna.
Yes, Maharaj.
How can you respect those who are disrespecting us?
By telling them that, okay, they are great, they are very great, and whatever they are doing is right. Mm-hmm. And that's how, and we have to think, okay, we are just focusing on Krishna, we are doing Krishna Seva, and let them realize, okay, whatever they are doing is right, but we will not, and we will try to keep some distance with them, not getting into any argument. But yes, just telling them, okay, they are great and they are doing fine. And our focus should be only on Krishna. Like whatever he is giving us, it is his wish. If he is taking anything away from us, but it is, and he is happy, then that is more important. So that's how we have to. And we have to give them prasadam, those who are disrespecting. We have to give them prasadam. Mm-hmm. That's the only.
Mm-hmm. Madan Mohan Prabhu.
That's the.
Yes. Madan Mohan Prabhu, how we can develop this quality of respecting those who are disrespecting us?
Hare Krishna Maharaj, Dandavat Pranam. Maharaj, by not offending them, yes Maharaj, and offering them prasad.
Uma Didi, do you want to say?
Yes, Dandavat Pranam Maharaj.
Dandavat?
Yes. Somebody tell anything about me. Maybe more than that fault for me with me. They tell little only that I have more fault. I have more sin.
Dr. Srinivas, I'm asking how can one respect those who are disrespecting us? How one can develop that quality? Krishna Sariya Prabhu, do you want to say?
Yes, Maharaj.
Yes.
The question is very simple, but to deal with them is very difficult. That is, Abhyasa Vairagyabhyam Tannirodha. That means if we have the Vairagyam and Abhyasam and get rid of that Raha Dvesha, likes and dislikes, and have fraternity, compassion, and friendliness with all perpetually will certainly will lead to that kind of situation, Maharaj.
Do you all remember that how Gaur Kishodas Babaji Maharaj behaved with those children who were throwing stones at Gaur Kishodas Babaji Maharaj?
Yes, Maharaj.
What he said?
He said, Krishna, you are becoming very naughty now.
Some boys rolling stone, but Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj saying, oh, Krishna, why you are throwing him stone? I will tell you, Yashoda. I will complain to Yashoda. Like everything thinking about.
He was thinking, Krishna become very naughty.
No problem.
And he's telling, okay, let me complain about you with Mother Yashoda. You are becoming too naughty. Yeah? He was showing some kind of vatsalya ras. He was not having any bad dealings with those boys who were throwing stone. He was seeing Krishna's hand in that activity. Without Krishna, nothing will happen. Without Krishna's sanction. So he could see Krishna's hand in that. So if a devotee develops this type of vision, if somebody is doing all these things with us, and Krishna must be there in the background. Otherwise, why he is doing like that with me? It is Krishna who is wants something to be changed in me. Something incorrect, wrong thing is there in me that he wants to take away. Then he is introspecting his own, faults. What is that wrong is there in me? How can I correct that? There was a devotee, Narsi Mehta, another Vaishnav in Gujarat. And that Narsi Mehta, he was 24 hours always engaged in service of the Lord. And he was a grosta, and his wife became very much worried. And she is every time telling, disturbing him, that you are not doing any job or anything. Always you are busy with this devotional activity, doing sankirtan, chanting holy name, all these things. How the family will be maintained? And there's 1 year it is coming and other year it is going. No reaction. Nothing is happening there. One day she become very much disturbing to Narsi Mehta. Then he thought, oh, maybe I have done some offense. That's why this disturbance is coming. Then he praying to Lord, oh Lord, please forgive my offense. I have done something wrong, some bad thing. That's why this disturbance is coming. Please forgive my offense. Actually, that day the wife was telling to him, your daughter grown up and then you're not doing anything, then how the marriage will happen? So when Narsi Mehta says like this, please forgive my offense, and immediately in his house one boy comes with his parents. And then he says, we came to see your daughter for marriage. We're looking for a good match. then the wife become very happy. Oh, nobody was coming to our house, and today somebody came. And then the boy was from very good background, and they both seen and they agreed, yes, marriage can be done. But the boy says, I have only 7 days left. I have to go outside foreign country. I'm doing job there. Then within 7 days, if marriage can be happened, then it is okay. Otherwise, I cannot. Then they agree anyway, the marriage proposals are not coming. So anybody, somebody came, then the wife agreed already immediately, Narsi Mehta's wife. Then she increased her pressure on Narsi Mehta. Now the 7 days marriage will be there. Arrange all the things, everything. Okay, Narsi Mehta says, I am going. And then he's going to his neighbor with a japamala in his hand, Hare Krishna chanting, and telling Prabhu, my dear sir, can you give some loan to me? They're saying, you are useless person. Whole day you are only doing all this chanting and everything, not doing any hard work. You lazy fellow, get out from here. Then he's not insulted by that, somehow. He was happily chanting his holy name, going from one house, next house, one village, two village, like that. He went to some villages he crossed, and he seen one stage is set and one sadhu is speaking Harikatha. And this Narsi Mehta is so much attracted for Krishna Katha. Immediately he sat down, and the Krishna Katha went on for 7 days. And when the Katha finished, and then he asked, what is date today? Oh, already it is past. Yesterday was that date. Already 1 day passed. Oh, what I will do if I go to my house and they will heavily chastise me, or what they will do, I don't know. Then he thought, on the way, I will tell a lie. That asking for loan, I went village after village, long distance. While coming, it become delayed. And when he enters into village, first person sees him, saying, Narsi Mehta, how you could do such a wonderful marriage? And he's saying, what happened? He's glorifying me or commenting or insulting me? And everybody is saying, Narsi Mehta, how you could do such marriage? We could not even imagine that we can ever do such type of thing. And everybody praising him. And surprised. Then he meet his wife by saying, why not you told me before that you have such a big contact? And what contact I have? Now you send that boy, that dark complexion boy, one boy came. He told that your husband sent me. And he brought so many rice, dal, sabji, all these things, milk. And he brought so many gold coins who came to for this marriage. And they taken some prasadam in our house. He given everybody one gold coin. And that is, he could understand what happened. Narsi Mehta could understand what happened. Krishna says that if you give yourself to me, then I take the responsibility what you have. Means what wealth, spiritual wealth you got, I take the responsibility to protect that. Yoga Khema Bahamyam. I take the responsibility for that. And what you have to get, I make arrangement. What spiritual higher upliftment you have to get, I will make arrangement for that. Krishna says that. But we don't have faith on that. Narsi Mehta was having grossed such love that he could forget all those things. He was always thinking about Lord, his service, Sravanas. He forget everything. But every moment we are remembering so many things. I have to do this, I have to do that. So many non-Krishna things. Krishna bhuli seijib anadi bahirmukh ataya maya tarade sansaradi. We are forgetting Krishna. So how the smaran will come? What is the process? The smaran. How the smaran will come? Madan Mohan Prabhu. How the smaran will come? Remembrance of the Lord?
By practicing Maharaj.
No. Damayanti Didi. How that smaran will come? Remembrance of the Lord.
By chanting or serving Guru Vaishnava.
Srinivas, Dr. Srinivas, do you know how that remembrance will come? Smaran.
Krishna's Daya.
Uma Didi, Karuna. Do you know how the remembrance will come? Smaran?
Yes, Maharaj. First came Sarda, Sarda to Sravan, Sravan to Kirtan, Kirtan to Smaran.
Very nice. First, one has to hear. The beginning of the service is to hear, attentively hear. Hearing is not just, coming in one ear and going in other ear. Some other mind is somewhere, not with the sound that is coming to us. One has to properly hear. That means he has to take that to heart and practice that in day-to-day life. That is Sravan. Then tell that thing, what you are hearing, to others. That is Kirtan. And if you do that, Sravan and Kirtan, then your remembrance of Lord will come. But we are not doing that. We may be coming and listening, but our mind is somewhere else, then nothing is staying.
Swamiji?
Yes. There is hole in the pot.
Talking about...
1 minute. Yeah. Have you finished this sentence? There are holes in the pot, and then so much things are coming, nectar may be coming, but nothing is staying because so many holes. So many other things we are thinking. Then where is that nectar is staying there? Our pot is something like that. So many holes. We are not properly listening. Yes, Srinivas, Dr. Srinivas, what you wanted to say?
You are talking about Swamiji, Maharaj, you are talking about Sravana Manana Nididhyabhyasa.
Sravana man?
Sravana Manana Nididhyabhyasa.
Sravan and Kirtan.
Sravan Manan.
Kirtan?
Kirtan. Yes.
Sravan means you do it through your ear, the sound. Yes. Kirtan means you do it through your mouth. That is a preliminary understanding of that, Sravan and Kirtan.
Yes, Sravan and Kirtan, okay.
But real Sravan has to be done through heart. That is known as Darshan. Darshan, proper vision to see things. When we are coming to Sadhu Guru Vaishnav, then we are coming for Darshan. Darshan means to develop proper angle of vision, to see things. A Sadhu will give us that vision. How we will see? What is the proper vision to see? The Sadhu will give us. That is proper Sravan. Then we can also help others to develop that type of vision. That is Kirtan. Kirtan means to fight against maya, illusion, misconception. That is Kirtan, the higher understanding of Kirtan. Fight against maya, misconception. Then automatically we remember Krishna. Through Sravan Kirtan, we automatically remember Krishna. Remembering Krishna means not just, memorizing, like the people, the students are memorizing by telling, different, we used to chant, when we are studying the Sanskrit, Rama, Ramo, Ramaha, we chanting like this, remembering, that is not really a smaran proper. Smaran means it has to come spontaneous way. Like Prahlad Maharaj is the example, smarane Prahlad. Prahlad is the example of remembrance. At all circumstances, difficulties or good time, he was constantly remembering Lord. So, when we are initiated, Guru is first telling us, you chant this mantra, but you avoid the offense. That is Sravan. When he is telling you, listen what I am saying, Guru is saying. And then when you are executing that properly, when you are following that properly, by chanting the holy name, by avoiding the offenses, then that is Kirtan. And then remembrance of Lord will come from that. Sravan, Kirtan, Smaran. That is the process there. But you are not listening properly. And then how can you do Kirtan? You will be telling your own mental concoction, mental ideas, misconception. That is not proper. So proper way of chanting the holy name is to have proper shravan, proper listening, proper hearing from the Vaishnava. That is the most important thing. Proper hearing. Without proper hearing, we cannot do proper chanting of the holy name. So we have to have a connection with the Vaishnava, not just initiation, but we have proper connection with the Vaishnava. Then we can chant the holy name properly. Sadhu Sanghe Krishna Naam Eimatra Chai Sansar Janite Ar Kono Vastu Nai. In the association of Sadhu, one has to chant the holy name, and by that one can cross over the mundane conception of this world, sansar. This is very, very important principle. So that's what I wanted to say. Any questions or comments anybody have for what we discussed today?
Hare Krishna Maharaj, Dandavat Pranam.
Dandavat, Madan Mohan Prabhu.
Maharaj, you mentioned that kirtan is used as a medium to wage war against Maya. Mm-hmm. In a higher conception. Mm-hmm. Maharaj, can you please enlighten us more on this, please?
Actually, you remember I told that when we are going to sadhu, then we are going for darshan, isn't it?
Yes, Maharaj.
We are going for darshan. So, when we are going for darshan, then that darshan means we are trying to eliminate all kinds of wrong visions that we have with us. Wrong vision. That is Maya. Maya has given us so much misconception, so many bad conceptions, illusionary conception. We may see a apple and we think that is, for our satisfaction. We may think like that. That apple is for my satisfaction. But sadhu will tell you, why are you eating? Have you produced an apple? Have you produced an apple? You got the seed, that is your property. Have you created that apple? You have not created it. And what right do you have to enjoy it? Who is the owner of that apple? If Krishna is the owner of that apple, then first you have to offer that to Krishna. Then you learn, I cannot use it for my enjoyment. If you are listening properly, then you will understand that I will not do that. Then he will correct you in that way and give you proper vision. Then you can also tell others, that is a fight against Maya. People are against, people are influenced by Maya. Then you have to help them on understanding that what you learned from the sadhu, you have to explain that. That is preaching. Preaching is the war against Maya. You have to preach what we are learning from a Vaishnava. So Saraswati Thakur, when he started his Gaudiya Math mission, he not only declared war against Maya, but he declared war against all other religious conception, which is not of that highest standard. Totalitarian war. He is known as Singha Guru. He cannot tolerate any misconception. That's why Saraswati Thakur used to say, if you want to get a place in Vrindavan, then stay in Kurukshetra, the war place. Kurukshetra is a very high place. After long separation, Radha Krishna meet again there. And at the highest necessity of Guru, because Radharani is thinking that I cannot see that Krishna, his coward boy. This Krishna is like a king. How can I get back that coward boy Krishna again? So in that needful circumstances, if one can do some little service to Guru, and that is the very appreciated. To a devotee, when he needs the most, if at that time if you do something, that is the most important thing. One who has already so much following, so much money, so much everything, and you do something there, you may not get any real appreciation or credit there. But who don't have anything, and if you do something there within need, And because that person is not asking anything from the Lord. And if you do something there, then Krishna says, oh yes, what I could not do, this soul could do that. That devotee is not asking anything from me and I could not do for that devotee. But this soul could do something. Then I become his servant. Krishna thinks like that. So that type of, you know, opportunity then Kurukshetra, and is also war place. It's a war place. Good and bad. So preaching, what Sasu Thakur meant, that to be in preaching. No. Dr. Srinivas, that is not proper. Love of God is not just control of mind and understanding the nature of self. Love means madness. People are mad in this world for money, for women, for honor, for followers, so many things. But devotees are mad for Krishna. We have to only know which madness is higher. Which madness is higher? That is the only thing. And Lord is also becoming mad after his devotees.
Maharaj, I have one question. Like, yes. There was one devotee. He said, like, if, Krishna gives a lot of difficulties in devotees' path so that, you know, they ask for something so that he doesn't become the servant of the devotee. Is it true? Because there was one devotee, he said this and I was a little confused.
What he said again? Can you repeat?
Yeah, he said, like, if Krishna becomes becomes servant of a devotee who does not demand anything from Krishna. So that's why he keeps giving difficulty to devotees so that he asks something.
That is actually misconception. Dandava Dhavananda Prabhu Haribol. How are you doing, Dhavananda? Your mic is muted. All right. Can you hear us, Jivananda? We could not hear anything from you. Anyway. Okay. So, it is not that Krishna is giving some difficulty that we should ask. No. Actually, he is giving difficulty to us so that we will enhance our dedication. We will get the higher level of, devotion. Like Prajavasis, Krishna given them some separation. And that separation helped them to release that Krishna's, devotion millions and trillions of times. Such high releasement is there that even Lord wants to release that. Lord Krishna thought, oh, what kind of satisfaction they are getting by this separation? I cannot understand this. What kind of releasement they are getting? And Krishna become Mahaprabhu, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He came in the mood of separation, not came in the mood of union. Krishna given so much difficulty, Radharani and Brajavasi, they are almost like that. Out of the separation, but they are getting something highest kind of releasement. Like the example is given, if you are watching some television, some tragedy scene is going on, and then you come, people are crying. Some people cry when they see this, all these tragedy scenes in movie. And if you switch off the television, then they will come and beat you. And you are crying, I stopped the television. And like that, then why they're coming and beating you? Because they're getting some taste in that. Same way. If the mundane thing has some, taste in that tragedy, then you can imagine how much releasement the devotees are receiving by that, transcendental, separation, love in separation. And that Krishna wants to give them. Je kore amar as tar kori sarbonas, tobe jodi na chhade as tar hoy daser das. Who is, aspiring to have me, then I will do sarvana. Sarvana means I will take away everything that is between me and him. And if even after that, he is not giving a hope of, you know, coming to me, then I become his servant. Krishna says that. Je kore amaras tar kori sarvanas, tabi jodi na chhade as tar hoy daser das. I become servant of his servant. So I want to stay in this mundane world, like taking so many bodies with mundane conception, or to die to live. You have to die with all this conception of this. If you want to hold something in this world, then you have to come back. But you leave everything, okay? Anyway, this does not belong to me. They are all like, you know, garbage, dustbin. So why should I be so much attached to that? Anyway, you're not going to stay with me.
So this means, Maharaj, one more thing. So non-devotees, I mean, they are not attached to the spirituality, some of them. So in that case, you see that they will not have this transcendental love, right?
They can never have. They can never have. What is this, Srinivas, you are saying? If only I feel Maharaj, that the duality.
I feel.
Is there no way for me to feel the separation? Devotees. You cannot understand it. The mood of separation, love, unless until you develop love first. How can somebody, if he not loved anybody, the mother has no love for a child, then how can he know the child is some far distance, what separation is? If he doesn't have any love for, don't have that inner connection with the child, then he can never feel. The mother can never kill. She can never feel that. First, the love has to be cultivated. And when it goes to the highest degree, then one can understand those things. Otherwise, it's not able to understand. It's all imagination. Gyan cannot come there. Philosophy has to do with some kind of rational exercise. But devotion, some faith is necessary there.
Swamiji, during Gokulashtami, when birthday of Lord Sri Krishna is celebrated,
Janmashtami.
Yeah. When the bhajan and kirtans are being played or sung, I get immersed and totally forget myself and think nothing but Lord Sri Krishna. So in that case, how could I feel otherwise if I come out of the situation afterwards?
Anyway.
Because I'm always thinking about Krishna.
You may go to some hospital. And you can sometimes feel some doctors are doing something. Then you feel, yes, I must be very much immersed in that. Now I have some knowledge about that operation. You may think like that. You might have seen so many operations that doctors are doing. You've seen that. But until and unless you are practically trained with all the development to become a doctor yourself, you don't understand those things. So you have to join that system. And then develop from class 1 to class 2, class 2 to class 3, and getting some practical experience of those things. This is a very scientific process. And that is Krishna telling in Gita. Tat vidhi pranipatena pariprasnena sevaya upadakshanti te jnanam jnanina tat darsana. We have to surrender to a Vaishnava, get initiated from him, take the seed of devotion, and then we inquire with the mood of service, pariprasneno sevaya, then the things will come to us. All these things is not a matter of imagination, cannot be explained actually, these all things, by some imagination. A blind man, how many times you explain him the rose flower is looking so beautiful, how can he understand unless he has developed the eye? So we are blind at present. Amagyano timirandasya. We are blind at present. Eye has to be given. Then we know all these things. Otherwise, we are just trying to touch like this, this is pillar and that is, some kind of wall. We are interpreting elephant like that at present. That will not going to help. We have to open our eyes, develop that eye. That has to be given. The eye has to be given to us. Then, it is possible. Otherwise, it is difficult to get. Eye is very important thing. Eye means the proper vision. Proper vision has to be given to us.
But Maharaj, I am still not, satisfied with the explanation, because you say that it is only in imagination.
Yes.
But perverted imagination, perhaps a perverted imagination.
Yes.
I may think a doctor or a lunatic or something like that, but then that is a reality.
There is a difference between theory and practical. Right. So somebody may tell you,
reality,
have you ever taken Bengali Rasgulla?
No.
Then I will tell you, Bengali Rasgulla tastes very nice. It is very nice thing. I can give you so many
experiences. Yeah, I have taken Rasgulla. Rasgulla I have taken. Yes.
Yeah, but have you taken Bengali Rasgulla?
Yes, Bengali.
Okay. Suppose you have not taken it, and somebody is telling you so many explanations about it. Until and unless you put that in your mouth, you don't know what he's talking about. Same thing. There is difference between theoretical understanding of things and practical understanding of that. It's a great difference. Namaste, Dr. Balesh Kumar ji. Can you hear us? Dr. Balesh? Okay. Can you hear
us?
Dhanavad, Dhavananda.
Sorry, I'm working at the moment as well. I'm watching your video.
I was thinking about you since few days. I've not seen you for quite some time. I was thinking what you are doing. How are you doing?
Maharaj, if you're free a bit later on, I'll call you. I want to give you a bit of an update, if that's okay.
Okay.
If it's not too late.
No problem. You can call me. I was just thinking that Maya is so strong. So, you are not, it's putting some difficulties to you.
Please don't say that.
we have to be very much afraid of Maya. Dekhi suni lage bhoy, taraiya loha nija paas. You know that song? Have you ever heard this song? Narottam Das Thakur says, by seeing and hearing, I am becoming afraid. How Maya deals with all these things.
Yeah, exactly.
So please, oh devotees, Vaishnav, please take me close to you. I am very much afraid. So we should never go away from that fear. A fear should be there. That is helpful. That is helpful to us.
Yes, that's a very nice, that's very good. I'll remember that.
Dr. Balesh, how are you doing? Hare Krishna. You have to unmute your mic.
Okay, I'm done. I'm fine. How are you?
We are doing good. Happy that you joined us.
I'm sorry I joined little late. I was busy in some other.
No problem. Dr. Balesh is a biologist from a top Indian institute. He got, PhD, ISC Bangalore. And he served, which organization you served for your, job in CCMB?
I served the National Geophysical Research Institute. National Geophysical Research Institute.
Yes, National Geophysical Research Institute. He served and
retired. Basically, I'm an arts scientist.
You are a?
Earth scientist.
Okay. Earth scientist. Okay. Not biologist.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Actually,
but I work in field of physics, chemistry, biology.
Yes. I am being invited for a talk by Nepal, Tribhuvan University and other university students this Saturday. I'm speaking on a topic. Does modern science study abiology in the name of biology? I'm speaking on that.
Okay, good.
You know what is the difference between biology and abiology?
You can tell me.
Abiology deals with non-life, and biology deals with life.
Yeah.
But
okay.
In the department of biology, we are only doing physics and chemistry of the atoms, molecules, all those things. We are not studying really life. Yeah. Life means that is thinking, feeling, willing, yeah. all those things. Anger, frustration.
Okay.
These things are not the found as the properties of matter, atoms, molecules.
Okay.
Electron don't have all these properties. Electron, proton, atoms, they don't have this property. They're only known by their mass, atomic number, charge, weight, all these things. They're not known with all these properties. But we are doing the same thing in biology and calling it biology, but we are studying abiology. So I'm going to discuss that if you are available, you can join 10:45 a.m. India time. It'll be that, program. And you are most welcome to join.
If you send me an email, I'll join.
Yeah, email will be sent to our group.
How long this meeting will go, the present meeting?
In question answer, some discussion. We have discussed today about the chanting of the holy name, like in this world, we have some sound. Every sound has some kind of conception. So in the in the spiritual plane, the entities of in this world, they can connect with that spiritual world through this conception of sound. Like Brahma is the first living entity of this material world, and he was not knowing what to do. He was afraid. Everywhere there is darkness. And then some sound came from above. Tapa, tapa, tapa. Then by the grace of Lord, he could understand tapa means tapasya. Then he started that severe austerity for many years. Then Vishnu become very pleased and given him Vedic knowledge. Because that's what he was looking for. But if you are looking, if you are looking to have a connection with the spiritual world, because this material world is known as a perverted reflection, like mirror. You see your left hand as right hand and right hand as left hand. So in the spiritual world, everything exists for Lord's purpose. In material world, we are using everything for our for misconceived self, for sense gratification, for satisfaction of mind, all those things. So to go from this misconception
or comfort, will you call it misconception or comfort? Will you call it misconception or comfort?
Misconception means when you don't have understanding of your real self and your origin. What is your real self? Are you atom? Are you molecule? Are you flesh, blood, bones? Are you these senses, mind, ego? What you are? You don't have proper understanding, then you are in misconception. And also that is not enough. You have to know about your origin and your relationship with that origin. If you don't know that, then you are having some misconception. So to clear that misconception, you need help. And that help comes in the form of sound from above. But when that sound is coming to you through a channel, then there are certain do and certain don't. So that don't means don't do that activity which will disturb the activities of that higher world. That will create some kind of displeasing atmosphere. That is aparad, offense. Don't do that. That guru tells you when he gives that sound, a qualified Vaishnava, he gives you sound and he tells you, you don't have to commit the offenses. Not that you just do service and you side by side continue offense. That will not going to help. So we discussed that elaborately whatever detail that we could. And, we were having some discussion on that.
Maybe I missed that. But anyway, let's see what you do in the talk in Nepal. I have one question.
Yes.
Do you do any portrait of science in what is soul? I want to understand what is soul. Is what it is? A physical entity or biological entity?
Soul is the part and parcel of the Lord. You cannot have an isolated understanding of soul. Like if you ask me what is nose, don't tell me about body. Just tell me what is nose. And I cannot tell you what is nose without body.
Okay.
Nose is only nose in with its relationship with the body. So in that way, soul can only be understood when you try to understand God. Without that, you cannot understand soul. Soul is part and parcel of the Lord. And by nature, it is the energy, tatastha shakti, the marginal energy of the Lord. So the energy is feminine. And shaktiman, from whom the energy originates, that is God, Krishna. And by nature, the shakti is supposed to serve shaktiman. That is the nature. Like nose, has a property of serving the body in helping the breathing, or eye has a property, or the teleological what you can say relationship with the body is to see that function. Same way, soul's nature is to serve Lord. That is its identity.
I see.
So only with that you can understand soul. Otherwise, without that you cannot understand soul. So you are, because we have some, you know, misconception about our real self, then we are getting all these misconceived forms, imaginative forms in the material world. We were like zygote, then two cell, four cell, eight cell, baby body, and then youth body, old body, like that, dog body, cat body, so many bodies we are getting. But what is the real form?
How to understand that more in detail? How to understand that more in detail? How to understand that more in detail?
Oh, to understand
about what is
To understand, you have to understand the process of surrender, saranagati. Tatvidhi pranipatena pariprasnena sevaya upadakshantite jnanam jnanina tattvadarsana. First, one has to surrender to a qualified saint, pranipat, and then inquire with the mood of service, like Parikshit Maharaj. You know Parikshit Maharaj? You heard him? You heard about him?
Yeah, I know.
He could not understand what he should do. Only 7 days left. Then he surrendered to his saint, Sukadev. And Sukadev Goswami was a great Vaishnava. And he instructed him how to engage properly and make his life success within the 7 days. Krishna also says that in Gita. A baby don't know.
Good. We'll keep in touch.
Yes.
Nishkama Santa, we'll keep in touch.
Yes.
I was trying to read that Punarjanam magazine, which is published in US.
Yes.
To understand this issue.
Sure. Dhruvananda Prabhu, you raise your hand. I see. You have something to say.
Maharaj, I don't want to digress, but just a quick, if you can answer very, quick, without sort of disturbing the main topic. I mean, in Durga and Kali, are there also energies of the Lord? If you can just quickly clarify for me, please.
What is that? I could not hear. Can you repeat again?
Durga and Kali Maharaj.
What happened with Durga?
Are there also energies? There are also energies of the Lord, right?
Yes.
I mean, are they? What kind of energy? I mean, if you don't want to go, don't want to go in detail. I mean, if you can answer quickly, that'd be all right.
Durga Devi is the Bahiranga Shakti.
Bahiranga.
That means.
And Kalima.
No, she is also a part of that. Different expansion.
Right.
Of that energy.
Right. Okay.
Bahiranga Shakti. The separated energy,
Separated energy. Yes.
That is avidya shakti. Avidya shakti, which makes us forget of Krishna. Yeah, which makes us forget of Krishna.
Avidya shakti. Okay. Very avidya. Interesting. And Kali is the same expansion, right?
Yes, same. home is Kala. Kala coming Kali. Shiva is Kal, and then the wife of Kala is Kali. Same. Shiva is the ego representation in this world. From him, from Lord Shiva, all this ego conception is coming. And he can also withdraw if you are surrendered properly as a Vaishnav to him. If you are surrendered to him with the mood of Vaishnav, then he will withdraw. Like Shiva is very affectionate and loving relationship he has with Sanatana Goswami, a devotee of Mahaprabhu. So it's a wonderful relationship that Shiva has. Arjun also devotee of Shiva, and Ravan was also, but their mentalities are different.
Yes.
So dark side and bright side. Shiva has both. Sambhu and Rudra has both side is there.
But they have a function. Durga had a function.
Durga means she is the jailer. Durga means jail, fortress. And then she is the jailer of this material world. She is putting all the jivas in jail. Jail of cycle of birth and death. Punarapi jananam, punarapi maranam, punarapi janani jatresan. That's why she has the mundamala. One body to another body, another body to another body. She's selling. That is the function of Durga. Durga Devi, Kali, they are doing that. But they are not happy with that. They're not happy.
People who worship Kali, then they are not. People who worship Kali, then obviously, they're not going to.
They're in Tamagun. They are worshipper of the Durga Kali. They are in Tamagun. Different demigod worships are in different gunas, explained in our scriptures. Sattva guna worship, Rajaguna worship, Tamaguna worship. But when you come to the platform of worship of Vishnu, then you are in Nirgun, Vishuddha Sattva platform.
Right, Maharaj. Thank you.
What, Dr. Srinivas? Yes, you want to say?
I've been listening to a very interesting and enterprising, beautiful, explanation for this. But then you were speaking about the soul theory to Dr. Balesh Kumar.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I've been tempted to ask you this question.
Mm-hmm.
Does soul has consciousness, Maharaj? Because
yes.
You say Krishna consciousness.
Mm.
This Krishna consciousness has got any relevance to in relation to soul?
Yes.
If that is so,
mm-hmm.
the soul will also travel, the consciousness will also travel with the soul, and ultimately I surrender into God and then I attain the liberation.
Is it correct? Soul has three things. Sat, Chit, and Ananda. Sat means eternal existence. Chit means consciousness. And Ananda means the fulfilling aspect. It aspires for fulfillment. So, soul has three aspects. Sat, Chit, Ananda. So, by itself, if you say soul by itself, then it is self-consciousness. But that is not true self. You are self, then another soul that he has itself. There are so many souls. What is the unity between all these souls? And that unity can only be understood in relation with the soul of all souls, that is God. And that is Krishna consciousness. Like the nose, eye, ear, nose, they have their individuality. But by themselves, you cannot understand what they are. But they can only be understood as the serving unit in the body. Same way, there may be so many souls, but their real identity can only come with their service relationship with the Lord. Otherwise, we don't know what they are. If somebody asks you, who are you? Then you say, oh, I am this K. Srinivasan. That identity is coming from your parents. Somebody is telling, I am this Patnaik and this, Banerjee and like this. That your identity is coming from your parents. So that's why when the Vedanta Sutra starts with Athato Brahma Jigyasa, inquire about your spiritual self, then the second verse immediately tells about Janma Dasyata. Inquire about from where you originated. Without understanding your origin, how can you know your real nature? You can only know your real identity from where you originated or what for. If you try to study a fruit without even understanding the tree and its whole process of development, then you don't understand what is that fruit. Fruit is only a moment of that, a developing concept, a dynamic concept of the tree. from the seed, the germination happens, then the leaves, all these things. And finally, the flower to fruit, all these things. That understanding has to come. Otherwise, you don't know what is that fruit lying somewhere without the tree. You don't know what it is. So the whole concept, entire, it has to be understood as a whole. Otherwise, the reductionistic understanding will not help. You understand it? Dr. Srinivas, you understand? Are you there? I think the no sound is coming. Maybe it's connection problem. So, any other questions or comments? Anybody have? We have a connection problem. We could not hear. All right. So, if there are no questions and comments, we are going to. Very nice, Dr. Srinivas, that you could understand it. I received your message. Your connection has some problem. So, if there are no questions and comments, we are going to conclude our Sangha here today. Thank you very much for your association. Vanchakalpaturugasya kipasindu bhayavachapatitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo namo namaha. Jai Saparika Sisi Guru Gauranga Gandharva Govinda Sundar Juki Jai Yamishnupad Paramahansa Paribhrajaka Jyot Guru Srila Bhakti Damodar Goswami Maharaj Ki Jai Yamishnupad Paramahansa Paribhrajaka Jyot Guru Srila Bhakti Madhav Puri Maharaj Ki Jai Yamishnupad Paramahansa Paribhrajaka Jyot Guru Srila Bhakti Nirmalacharya Goswami Maharaj Ki Jai Yamishnupad Paramahansa Paribhrajaka Jyot Guru Srila Bhakti Sundar Govinda Dev Goswami Maharaj Ki Jai Yamishnupad Paramahansa Paribhrajaka Jyot Guru Srila Esi Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada Ji Maharaj Ki Jai जय विष्णुपाद परमहंस परिव्राज जोत गोशिला भक्ति रक्षक श्री गोस्वामी महाराज की जय भगवान शिला भक्ति सिद्धांत संस्था को प्रभुपाद जी महाराज की जय महाभागवत शिला गोरकृष्णदास बाबा जी महाराज की जय सच्चिदानंद भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर की जय वैष्णव सर्वम जोगेन्द्रदास बाबा जी महाराज की जय बलदेव विद्यावर्षण प्रभु की जय नरोत्तम दास ठाकुर की जय कृष्णदास कविराज गोस्वामी महाराज की जय वृंदावन दास ठाकुर महाशय की जय रूपानुग गुरुवर्ग की जय नमाचार्य हरिदास ठाकुर की जय प्रेम से बलो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गौर शिवासादि गौर भक्त बिंद की जय सर्वदामोदर रायंदा जी भक्त बिंद की जय मुरारी गुप्त प्रभु की जय सपार्षद नित्यानंद प्रभु की जय सपार्षद महाप्रभु की जय भक्ति देवी वृंदा देवी की जय गंगा देवी जमुना देवी की जय ग्रंथराज श्रीमद भागवतम की जय चैतन्य चरितामृत चैतन्य भागवत की जय भक्तराज प्रहलाद महाराज की जय शुद्ध भक्ति विघ्न विनाशन भगवान नृसिंह देव की जय जय श्री जगन्नाथ बलदेव सुभद्रा सुदर्शन जीव की जय जगन्नाथ पुरी धाम की जय मायापुर नवदीप धाम की जय अपराध भंजन पाठ श्री कुलदीप की जय जय श्री गुप्त गोवर्धन की जय जय श्री सदा शिव गंगाधर जीव की जय जय श्री मथुरा वृंदावन धाम की जय जय श्री श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरी गोवर्धन की जय जय श्री चैतन्य सरस्वत मठ की जय तथा विश्वव्यापी सेवा समूह की जय तथा विश्वव्यापी सेवक बिंद भक्त बिंद की जय जय ध्रुवानंद प्रभु की जय मदन मोहन प्रभु की जय दामयंती दीदी की जय उमा दीदी की जय डॉक्टर श्रीनिवास डॉक्टर बालेश कॉल्म वेलन ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स की जय समवेद भक्तबिंद की जय हरिनाम संकीर्तन की जय जय गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि हरि बोल हरि बोल हरे कृष्ण
भक्त निष्काम संत महाराज की
जय गुरुदेव दंडवत हरे कृष्णा।